Hello guys, and welcome to the third episode of the Cura Advanced Settings 2019 here at Architects3DP. In the last episodes, we downloaded and installed Ultimaker Cura, made a custom profile for our 3D printer, the Architects3DP i3, and also made custom profiles for the filaments we're gonna be using in this series. Finally, we had an overview of the new interface we'll find in Cura 4.3. Today, we're going to start with the customization of the settings themselves, and we're gonna see how changing the parameters in the basic settings will affect our prints, so let's get into it. But before starting, be sure to click here in the subscribe button and to ring that bell to be notified when new cool stuff is uploaded. If you do it, it will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you. As always, we'll first open Cura. When we first open Cura 4.3, we'll appear in the interface we analyzed in the episode 2. If you haven't watched it, please do it through the link in the description. To start, I'm going to drag and drop the popular 3D Benchy 3D model in STL into the canvas. The 3D Benchy is a great model to challenge different features of the 3D printers, and we're going to be using it a lot in this series. By the way, you'll find the download link in the description. Once in the canvas, we'll see the model in green color, since it's the color of the filament we created in the first episode. In this prepare tab, make sure you have selected your 3D printer, in our case this one I created for this series named Architects3DP i3 2019. Also, this is the filament I created, and on the right, the basic settings, where we're going to jump in a few moments. Here in the model visualizer, a part of the green of the model, we can see some areas in red. These areas will represent the overhangs, and in most models, these overhangs will be printed on top of sacrificial structures that we'll call from now supports. Since the 3D Benchy is small, and due to its geometry, we should be able to print it successfully with no supports at all, as you will see later. I'm gonna jump now to the preview tab, and as you can see, here we have the Benchy properly sliced according to our settings. Here guys, we're starting with the source of this video, so pay attention and remember these few things, because you're gonna use them every time you make a print. The first setting is the layer height, that comes in a form of a slider. By default, it's set to 0.15 mm, and this means that each independent layer will be 0.15 mm tall, with 10 independent layers, we'll get 1.5 mm of the model. So as you can imagine, such a detailed scale. However, we can change this layer height, what will influence not only the quality of the model, but also the printing time. Shorter layer heights means more quality, but also more time. Taller layers will reduce the quality a bit, but will also be more time efficient. The key will be to determine a balanced value for each model we want to print. Now let's see how this value will influence in our print. At a 0.15 mm, the printed model will have 319 layers, and the printing process will take 1 hour and 11 minutes according to Cura. The quality, as you can see on the preview, is pretty damn good. We'll see the printed object later to compare. If you reduce it to 0.1, the print will require this time 478 layers to print the 48 mm in the Z of the Benchy, and this time will take 2 hours and 5 minutes. The infill slider did also move automatically from 10% to 20%, since it's a preset from the basic settings on Cura 4.3. If we move the layer viewer to the layer, for example 65, and change the layer height back to 0.15 mm, you can see this infill difference. It has like half of the walls now.
Don't worry about this infill change, since we'll learn how to modify it manually in the next episodes.
If we move it to 0.06 now, the infill will be set back to 20%. The quality now, as you can see, is insane, with 796 layers to complete the 48 mm tall model. But the print now will take 4 hours and 19 minutes, which is almost 4 times the print time with the 0.15 mm layer height. We'll only use these 0.06 settings when we want to make really perfect prints. If we go to the other way, 0.2 will sacrifice a bit of print quality, but will also reduce the printing time down to 1 hour and 3 minutes, which is great.
Personally, 0.2 mm is the layer height I used to use in almost all my prints.
We can even go higher, like for example 0.3 mm, but here we'll see a clear reduction of the quality that will make our prints not good enough in some cases, especially in prints where we have curved sides such as this one. This time the print time will be reduced to only 44 minutes, and this could work perfectly if the print had more orthogonal planes. 0.3 is the maximum layer height I recommend you to use with a 0.4 mm nozzle, and only in orthogonal 3D models with vertical walls, as I said before. If we go to 0.4 mm layer height, here in the simulation we'll see just taller layers, but if we actually make the print, the quality will be just too bad. So I will recommend you to go with 0.3 maximum, as I said before.
To demonstrate what I'm saying, I have printed a Benchy with all the different layer heights we just analyzed, so you can compare the print quality yourselves. It is not the same watching the print quality in video than in real life.
but I'm gonna try to show you all the models and compare the quality. In this side view, we can compare the quality of the keel. As you can see, it's more than acceptable starting at 0.2 mm. Taller layers will show an irregular surface here. In this other view, we can compare the quality of the roof. As you can see, it's acceptable in most of the prints, but obviously at shorter layer heights, more layers, and as a consequence a softer inclined plane. In taller layers we'll be able to differentiate each of the steps of the roof. In this last view we can compare two parameters. The first will be the chimney, that since it has almost vertical walls, will look good in most of the models. However, if we compare the circular window, here with smaller layer heights we'll have a more perfect circle. Depending on our level of exigence for each case, we could for example determine that the acceptable quality starts from the 0.2 mm layer heights and lower.
That's why I choose 0.2 mm layers in almost all my prints.
Alright, so now that I've compared the layer height settings, I'm gonna jump to the second one, featuring the infill percentage. As I announced before, this will control the infill density inside the print.
For this setting, I'm going to load the 20mm test cube I created in last year's Cura Custom Settings series, and you will be able to download from the link in the description.
So once the model is in the build plate, I'm gonna scroll the layers down to the 25, and I'm going to start changing the values. It is at 20% by default, and if we move it to 10%, as you can see it has more free space, and if we move it higher, it will become more and more solid. I've made a few prints, as you can see, featuring the 0, 20, 50% and 100% infills, so you can have a better look. Just comment that this time, for more infill, the printing time will be longer and will also use more grams of filament. For the 0% infill, the print will take 14 minutes and 3 grams of filament. For the 20% infill, will take 18 minutes and 4 grams of filament. 50%, 25 minutes and 6 grams of filament. Twice the filament that with a 0% infill. It can make a huge difference in bigger prints. Finally, using a 100% or solid infill, the print time will be increased to 54 minutes and we'll use 10 grams of filament. As always, we'll choose our best option depending on each 3D printing case.
We have another option inside the infill section, that is gradual infill. For that, I'm going to bring back the 3D Benchy 3D model and I'm going to explain you how it works.
Before starting, I'm going to set the infill density to 50%. As you can see, changing in between layers, quite a solid infill. Now, if we activate the gradual infill option, what it's going to do is to take our set value that was 50% and use it for the parts directly behind the bottom shell of the object.
From there, it will reduce the infill percentage proportionally to the minimum.
As you can see here inside the Benchy, it will make the top layers in yellow, directly below, in orange, and with a 50% infill, we find the infill, and as we go down, this density is getting lower and lower, till we get to the bottom solid layer again.
This feature is very cool to save materials in bigger prints, while making sure we have a solid structure under the solid top layers.
With this configuration, the print will take 1 hour and 15 minutes and 4.7 meters of filament. Instead, if we deactivate the gradual infill feature, the print will take the same time, but this time it will use 4.93 meters of filament. We'll only save 23 centimeters of filament in this small print, but as I said before, this feature will have more impact in bigger prints. To have a better idea, I'm going to scale the print to 380%, and as you can see the print time without the gradual infill activated will be 1 day, 11 hours and 42 minutes. We'll use 600 grams of filament and 201.26 meters. If we activate the gradual infill feature at this scale, now the printing time will be reduced to 19 hours and 47 minutes. We'll use 252 grams of filament or 84.45 meters. As you can see on screen, the difference is huge. So this is definitely a feature that you should have in mind for future big prints.
I'm going to analyze now the last two features of the basic setting, guys. And for that, I'm going to reduce the model back to 100% size, set a 0.2 layer height and a 20% infill. As you may remember,
before I told you here in the prepare section, that in red we'll find the overhangs that will need supports according to the parameters in the custom settings menu. So now if we go to preview and activate the supports here in the basic settings section, as you can see, Cura will create the necessary sacrificial structures to complete the print successfully. We'll tune them later in a dedicated episode, so don't worry about this creepy look.
I'm gonna print it with support, so you can have a look at the final result.
As you can see, the print came out very dirty, and needs a lot of post-processing by removing all the supports using for example a pair of pliers. As I told you before, we won't need to use supports for this particular 3D model.
Last but not least, we only have left the bed adhesion parameter.
That will simply alternate in between the skirt and brim adhesion modes that we'll analyze in a future episode. If we deactivate the adhesion tick, the print will start with a prime of the extruder around the model, as you can see here in the simulation. And then, after a retraction, it will move to the actual 3D model. It will make the model itself more clean, and we won't need to remove any parts later on post-processing. However, if we activate the adhesion feature, this time the print will start with a prim that will be touching the actual 3D model.
It will stick it more strongly to the bed, but we'll have to remove the prim when the print is finished, using some blade or cutter. Also, this feature will increase the printing time a little bit.
This feature is very handy, for example, to print with a small surface in contact with the bed, slender 3D models, and materials such as ABS or PETG.
And that was the last setting we're gonna see in this episode, guys.
In the next episode, we'll finally jump to the custom settings section, starting with the first tab, quality. So definitely stay tuned for the next video, guys.
Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects 3DP if you still haven't, hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this video so more people will be able to enjoy with this project. And as always, a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp, clicking here in the top right corner, or in the link in the description. Remember that becoming a Patreon, you will get access to all the necessary components for this project, as well as all the past projects in the channel, and much more rewards that you can check in our Patreon page. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video!